Okay, chaps, recap. Where are we? So since the last episode, recording yesterday, I watched a couple streamers and gleaned a few keen observations from their playthrough. First of which is the importance of horses. There's a tooltip saying that having spare horses in your inventory will actually increase the speed at which your party moves. If we go to inventory, so I need to start buying up sumpter or saddle horses, sumpter and saddle horses as soon as we can. So we struggled a lot yesterday with just trying to catch enemies. I'm hoping we're going to offset that by literally having, let's see, we got how many people? 25. So the two things that are going to limit party size is not only going to be maximum command size, but also number of horses. I'm not even kidding. So got a horse, two horses. Because your troops will actually ride spare horses, and that increases your speed. So let's leave our group at 25, and then just start buying up horses wherever we can get them. We've got 3,600 gold. Okay, so let's start buying horses. Quest-wise, I also really want to focus on completing this Nerezzi's Folly thing. Let's see. My products, they don't sell horses, do they? Let's go to Onira. So check, so moving speed is 5.2, which is pretty good, I think. I mean, obviously the other thing that's going to help us is riding, so I need to maybe put some points into riding as well. Riding the map as much as possible, fight on horseback. Ooh, these mountain bandits, we're going to go take them on. Overpriced raw materials. Of course, we'll keep doing missions like this if we can. So the other thing about keeping the horses in your inventory is it allows you to have more carry capacity. Dobakis, it's been a while. I love the way they animated the faces. So what do we need? 2 units of leather. Sure. Now what's the bet we can actually find 2 units of leather in the city? Steep horse. 46 speed. Okay, we're just going to buy whatever horses we can. As long as they are less than 200 gold. Velvet leather. Are we spending, what, 400 on, 500 on 2 hits of leather, and he's going to pay us 600. So not a lot of profit, but that's fine. Yarl blood axe, that's too expensive. Lamina, shoulder guards, what are we wearing? 9. I'll have them. Then we will lock all the food items. And the items, we'll lock the horses, of course. Leather, sell everything else. Talk to this lad, give him the leathers we bought. So we make almost no profit. But, I mean, as long as it improves our relations with him. Yeah. Up to 22, look at that. Relations with Urias the Velvet Weaver. Okay, so fair enough. So that's gonna piss off some people. Relation minus 20. Relation 0. Relation 22. But Vespers Vesilops. Ah, okay, so maybe, like, I've pissed this guy off, but he could be a key way of getting level 3 troops. Warning. Is that my maximum speed? Captured by bounty hunters. I think we can try to do that. Stobbicus. Grieving with a nose too, no concern. Self's dead drunk, giving another brand. Now the boys are all trussed up, just animals. How can I help? Make it worth your while. 1,000 dinars? Hell yes. Okay, so we just keep running around, keep doing missions, keep buying horses. expected change, food change, loyalty, criminal rating. Aha, I'm gonna go to the hideout then. So this is our clear out the hideout mission. We have trained infantrymen, imperial infantrymen. I'm betting that that's gonna be doable, but first of all, I wanna take on these mountain bandits because that's just good money. Hope this other, the other group is gonna help us. Okay, so surrender or die. Just send the troops. We have this other big group helping us. We lost archer, a trained archer. Imperial veteran archer, yeah, fine. Veteran infantryman, we got three wounded, so we're gonna wait until these lads are healed up. And we're gonna clear out that. Hill tribe hideout. Jagged spear, don't need that. Choose. Off scale boarding. None of the inventory that I've noticed, it just has taken a bit of, you know, just figuring it out and learning, frankly. I didn't realize the fact that your inventory space like this is increased by your troops, your pack animals. So mules, just mules alone. Horse, steep horse. The mules only help you have more increased carry space. It doesn't actually help your speed on the world map. Cool. Okay, so who are we looking for? What is that? I'm Stobicus. Pleased to meet you. What can you tell me? Yarios. The Toga Castle. Really, I just need to wait. That's too far away. Maybe we just camp before taking on that hideout. How many wounded do we have? Two wounded. Oh, one other thing. In the clan page, so I should make myself. Not scout, quartermaster. And then based on the skills, he'd be a good scout. Jin, where's healing? Ah, medicine. Surgeon. Perfect. Engineer. Scout. Four. So we've filled all four of our spaces and we can have one more companion. Morning Doomsday. Presumably the fourth companion will not have a role. He will just fight. Bounty hunters. Found them ourselves. Let's see. 8, 10, 12 mountain bandits. That's very doable. Just gotta wait until... Who's wounded? The archers. Okay, in that case, I don't even have to worry about that. Wait until nightfall. Hope that there's people in the area isn't going to mean that they're going to actually join in the fight. 5, 2, and 2. Who's joined us? Looks like infantry lads. Everyone, follow me. Go get them, boys. Javelin time. Look how slow we are. I think we should stop buying heavy armor like this. Just keep the armor to like leather, lamellar stuff. I mean, yesterday we had great success throwing javelins off of horseback. Notably, we did 400 damage on a full tilt, full charge, max power headshot javelin throw. Pretty interesting. Is that an enemy? That's an enemy. Oh, how much damage was that? Ow! Oh, Jesus, he almost one-shot us. Is this the leader? That was one javelin to the face, took almost all our health. But I pulled it out of myself like you used to be able to do. So when it comes time to fight the boss man, I don't know whether we're gonna charge him to a duel or not. I'm gonna have my ads help me because of all the hit point damage I took. I don't fight duels with brigands. Get in there, boys. Armor we're wearing is the best we could afford. You can just assume whatever armor I'm wearing, it's the best I can afford. Ooh, a highwayman of cavalry. This is all. I only have 13 head armor. Yeah, that's not very good. Buy ourselves a nice helmet. 12 head armor. What about what the rest of the lads are wearing? 10 head armor. Fur cap, 11. Well, 3. That's better. It would be nice if you could auto assign improved armor. Okay, completed. I don't even have to go back there. Okay, that's cool. So, this highwayman, do we want to have him join us? No, we only want Imperial troops. Keep our lads pure. Devon District, ransom prisoners, trade. Keep our horses. Sell everything else. Food variety. So I need some more dates. Need more dates. Okay, so in times like there seems to be downtime. Like you'll do a battle. Okay, what's our speed? 5.5, 4.9. Good. So we're like, you do a battle, your lads get injured, then you need some time to heal. So I think what we'll do then is, when it's time to heal, we'll go chase down leads on that story mission. Send the troops. Don't bother with the looter, not worth capturing. Get like 5 gold for a looter, I think. Recruit. Archers, we need archers. Money's looking good. See what a difference now it makes when you can actually catch the looters. We spent most of God knows how many hours playing yesterday. 8 hours just running off the bandits, not being able to catch them. How many in total do we have? It's 23. Let's keep that up to 25. Oh, what do you need? Overpriced raw materials. That's just gonna piss off this weaver lad again. Troops. Oh, hell yes. Bigler recruit. Wait a second. Vigler recruits. Imperial recruit becomes Imperial infantryman. How did the, where do the Viglers sit into this? It's troops. Imperial. Empire. Oh, they become cavalry. Okay. Davis, I love it. Absolutely love it. I don't want cavalry just yet. We need to deliver the herd. Absolutely. We'll always do these deliver the herd missions. This is like free money. Can help. Fine. Bostrom, is that where we're heading? Crafting. I haven't actually done any crafting yet. I don't have any skill in blacksmithing. What we should do is maybe start collecting iron ore wherever we can find it, and wood and stuff like that, then head over to the blacksmith area in the city and just see if we can do some of that. We haven't tried that yet. Got fencing stone goods. Sorry, who am I supposed to be giving these things to? Senor the Dyer. And we're going to keep buying horses. Steep horse we'll take. We've got 5 spare horses. Takes a lot of iron and hardwood. Well, we should in that case then start stockpiling iron and hardwood. Why don't we buy a few mules just to get our, there we go, carrying capacity up to 1,000. Just because of reasons. Because he has the food, butter, meat, we have 4 olives, 2 cheese, 2 now, beer, 2 dates, hardwood, and buy at Onira for 11, silver ore. So can I actually wear my studded strip shoulders in the city? Imperial mail over leather, look at that, isn't that beautiful? Noble harness. Interesting, so you can only wear certain type of stuff. Imperial lamella over leather. So hang on, if I can buy studded strip shoulders, can I just put these across there as well? Let's try that. What do you want? Fencing stolen goods? No thanks. Recruit troops. 24, 25. We have our troops. My cloak go. Aldine, thank you for following. Okay, so you can't wear that with this outfit. Apparently. Because reasons. Looters we're not going to bother with. Let's see. Let's keep investigating Neretzi's folly. We're looking for someone out there by her toga. Ooh, a hideout. Yeah, looters. Render or die. And the lad's in. No need to fight that. But we are pretty much done fighting looters in hand to hand. Ourselves, that is. Actually, one thing we should remember from the previous Mountain Blade is just because we found a hideout doesn't mean we should go clear it out right now. We should wait until someone here gives us a mission to go do it. Well, look, there's horses here. Oh, yes, look at how cheap the horses are. A sumpter horse, is that even worth buying for your troops? I don't know if it is. Sturgeon, trotter, speed is 44. 46. Okay, so Midlands Palfrey. Buy loads of those and saddle horses. Grain and butter. Thank you, my man. Alden123, you're very kind. At respect that you did a 24-hour stream. I can't imagine that. How many horses? 1, 5, 8, 10, 5, no, 11, 13. Okay, let's just keep this for 14 horses. Sturgeon Hunter, speed or maneuverability is nice. Family feud, deliver herd to Lagetta. Might as well do that. I just have to hope that Lagetta is on the way to where we want to go. Mountain bandits could be worth fighting. Render or die. Attack. Ah, so I do have cavalry.
Footman! Forward!
Kind of forget how you order your
infantry. Take
command.
Over command!
No, that's not at all what I meant to do.
Infantry!
Three.
Forward!
I was trying to see how do you... How do you tell your infantry to switch to their pole arms? Fuck it, everyone just charge. Archers,
move.
Stay where you are.
Put
infantry.
Me.
Attack. Oh, yeah. Javelin! I still love the way when you throw a javelin and hit someone in the chest, it like throws them off their feet. Amazing. Harriman took down Oberon the Robber. Damn it, Oberon. What's the button for calling horse? This Harriman's taking out my followers. It's crazy. Everyone,
kill
charge. Oh, this Harriman has wrecked all of my followers. Yay, down he goes. We lost as a recruit. I wish I would tell you how much they are worth. Sell. Take him captive though. Okay, so we got 6 archers and get some more archers, I think. Menevleton, I think that is the spear using lad. I'll do that. Oh, sweet. Your attacks cause more morale loss. Kinda zoom, but I mean hell. I'm just glad that the waiting is finally over, and based on what I've played so far, it's just fucking It's so good. It's everything I was hoping for. Not perfect by any means, but so good. So good. Deliver the herd to La Guetta. I have to admit, I get distracted very quickly and easily. Poros, let's go sell this captive here. Only 6 hours. Oh, dude, get on my level. Up at 8. I'm meant to go. Wait, companion wise, so we've got a surgeon, we've got a scout, wanderer, tavern, cursed, red. Let's hire this lad. And we've got our four companions. Tell me about yourself. Let's see, a couple of bulls, so many others. This guy's a dedicated fighter. Hell yes. 2,300. Wow. No, that's too much. Let's take a look at Malaya the Accursed. How much does she cost? 790. Welcome. Town center, trotters, northern spiked battle axe. Wow, that's really good. 73 cut, 77 cut. Now, here's the new recruit. Imperial charger, there you go. And what else? A bunch of random reps. Jagged spear, go for it. I'm gonna keep buying however many cheap horses I can. I think this means we can get rid of some of our mules. We have 26 people. Empire peasant. Get rid of him. So we're back up down to 25. So we literally need 25 horses. 10, 23. Good. So we have loads of horses. We should be quite quick now. 6.4. We take on 21 forest bandits. Now we're mostly wounded. And my lads are mostly wounded. Wow, that's a lot of bandits. I'll take that on just yet. Okay, so clan-wise, I'm the quartermaster. Oberon is the scout. Miller the Accursed. What are your skills like? She's good at roguery. Jin, who's good at medicine, is also decent at scouting, which is a pity. Engineering is... what, that last one? I wish I'd realized this about the horses earlier on. Would have made the first 5 hours of this campaign so much easier. We literally spent 5 or 6 hours just running after bandits, being able to catch them. So the other thing about healing, why do I have to have certain supplies to actually go to poison Jolana? I do have to. If I buy healing supplies, is that going to help? Wonder. We've also got to pick the right time for us to pledge allegiance to one of the factions and start fighting in wars. Stobicus, here are your horses. Troops, recruits, 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 25, trade. Not yet, I don't even know how to, if I'm honest. Midlands Palfreys, these are good. Okay, so let's see, 10, 13, 16, 18 horses. 19, 20, 21, 22. 23. So let's see. Four, 25, 30. Now we can get our numbers up to 30. Still be nice and quick. I'm probably overdoing it with the horses. What hell? Escort merchant caravan, that's quite a rough one. The last time we did it, we failed with quite a lot of bandits. I think our lads are not strong enough yet. Look how fast we are, 6.5 speed. Hell yes. Render or die. Oh, we lost. Wow, a lot. See, the AI is pretty stupid with how it uses the archers, apparently. So apparently anything above looters we shouldn't be auto-resolving. Six plus three is nine. And only two archers. Yours. One thing I really want is an auto gear upgrade system. Just so that my followers can automatically get better gear. Who's in there? Crotor. Who's Crotor? Mina. I'm Stobicus. Where can I find Garios? Neocris. I should probably pay better attention to the name of the person I'm looking for. Ironix, Disporan. 21 Forest Bandits. How do we feel? Garios. Looking for Garios. Yuck. So my cavalry are quite wounded. Most of my troops are wounded. Azif. For real though, finding a particular nobleman can be quite difficult. Draw die. Troops. Yeet. I should probably also be giving some thought to looking for particular companions that'll have skills that will be better suited for the jobs I want to give them. Caravan, villagers, caravan. Caravans. Family feud, deliver the herd, we'll do that. And what the hell, we'll do the family feud as well. There have been Doomsday. The Kurgits have pretty much taken over most of the Empire already. You can see there. These are all. Look at the Kurgit taking over Norse land as well. Okay, so we're delivering to Quiers, and we help him with the family feud here in Nyokuts. Take a walk through. Oh yeah, the old herd quests could fuck right off, they were the worst. Who am I looking for? Family feud? Talk to Leviolus. Oh wait, I didn't get that other lad. First, shit. Or is this him? This is Oberon the Robber. Okay, this is a fuck up. Let's go back to that village that gave us quest. Get that lad to follow us. Then we go handle the following family feud. I think it's Menacles. Talk to Leviolus. Looking for Leviolus. Where is he? There he is. I love the character we've created, this throwing weapon specialist. Well, we can always get rid of the robber and the accursed person. I'm just hiring whoever's cheapest. Money's a little tight right now. We found one guy in a tavern who wanted almost 4,000 gold for him to join us. So I'm assuming he would have much better stats than these robbers and a curse that we've hired. Come with us. Let's go. And we are talking to who? Danos of Dredios. Helikos. We're going in the wrong village. Radios, that's where we're going. We had like 5,000 gold a little while ago. Decius Danos. Mate, move your ass. Look how amazing the models look and how good the graphics are and how good the horse animations are. Look at the hair on the horse's neck. Horse's mane. Isn't that amazing? Done such a good job. I feel like I'm playing third-party Battle Brothers. Loving it. When it comes to a fight, it could be a tough one. Obron has come in to help us, but like, how come my other companions don't help me as well? Is there not some way to give orders or like options? Kick bash, sheath weapon, drop weapon, don't do that. Caps lock, toggles, walk and run. Where's your armor, the robber? No, you can't issue orders now. I pressed F1, nothing happened. Just saved. One thing I've learned is equip your weapons before talking. Because if things get nasty. Wait, I've done something wrong here. Where's our follower lad? For goodness sake. Danos of Dredios. But where's that follower tit? That I failed to convince him to come with me. I think I didn't read what it said. Yeah, there's Levios. What the hell didn't he come with? Where the fuck is he? What is going on? Nessus. Thanos. Hey, what? I'm confused. Okay, for God's sake, could we take Levielos to Dredios to face Danos of Dredios? Dredios. Do I have too many companions? I think that's why. We make him the engineer, will he then appear? Obron, Dress, Dredius, Thanos, Jin, Valia. Okay, looks like we need to get rid of that other person we hired. Layer. Kicker from the clan. Obron, Decius. Okay, now I don't know why this dickhead isn't joining us on this mission. I had this issue before with this mission. Normally the guy in the story mission just runs along with you. Obron's on his way, and now talking to this guy, he's just gonna say, like, whatever. Stobbicus, I have a quick question. Never mind. But we gotta figure out why this fucking idiot won't join us in the village. Leviolus, what is your problem? Let's see, let's to discuss. I have a quick question. The position in the clan. No longer need you as an engineer. Holding. Last seen it, Dreadios today. Is he wounded? Maybe that's why. I don't know if I want to go to Imperial Legionaries yet. Let's leave that for now. He's not wounded. Maybe I should kick him from my clan. Does that mean he's now not with me? Oh, what does that mean for the quest? Convince to take Laviolos. Last seen at Dreadios. This is super annoying now. This guy has just fucked off. If we just straight up attack the guy who's part of the quest, maybe then the quest will just succeed. I think we need to go back to this village, or we'll just forget this stupid fucking mission and go deliver the herd. Okay, that's the first time a mission like that has pretty much failed. Wait here for some time, recruit troops. Forget it, whatever. If we have time, we'll come back. Let's go deliver this herd. $78 a day, it's not nothing. Render or die. Nice, good level ups. We've only got 3 archers, so we need 5 archers. And I think we'll hang on to upgrading these guys because they're quite expensive to upgrade. Quest failed, family feud, whatever. Stupid fucking quest anyway. Who are we talking to here? Kenar Mutton Pie. One thing I'm noticing about the various people that you can talk to in the cities is that doing missions for some of them will piss off other people inside that same city. So if there's like 5 representatives within the city, you're not going to be able to have good relations with all of them, is what I'm guessing. Army of poachers. I don't want to take on desert poachers. They're going to suck. Desert horse. And nice and quick. Ooh, Midlands Palfrey, they're nice and cheap and have good speed. 1028. 30 horses. So we can increase our total numbers up to 30. We're currently sitting at 18. Good, so we can hire 12 more peasants. 33 looters, reckon we can take them on? Up on our 14 of us. 6 of which are Imperial veteran infantrymen. Not the time now. Okay. We it's going to cost 100 gold to upgrade each one. Don't have them as much money as I would want. I want to get to like 2,000, 3,000 gold. Where are we heading to? We picked on Jelmaris. Yeah, we running around on foot turned out to totally not be the right approach. Troops. Trade. I was running on foot because I wanted to increase my athletics. That turned out to not be worth it at all. He wants us to fence stolen goods. No thanks. Where's Leviolos? Who's this fucking idiot? Common thief deserves the gallows. Looking for someone. Leviolos. Take me to him. He is Leviolos. Can we get him to join us? Alright. I'm not sure I want to hire anyone called the Accursed. That should be me plus three companions. Yes. Got none. Oh, yeah. Trying to find these nobles is a pain in the ass. So I suppose we just keep bouncing through villages doing missions here. And whenever we come across a nobleman, talk to them and see if we can get a tip of where the nobleman we're looking for is located. Daughter found, that's very doable. Family feud is annoying. I think one quest at a time is the way to go. Stobicus, yes, I'll find your daughter. Even if for no other reason other than the fact that I get distracted so easily. Ziocris. Bring her back to Neocris. Visit the nearby villages of Neocris. Search for clues. I don't see any tracks, so we'll just go to the nearest village. The Geron. Stobicus. Garios can be found where Garontor Castle. We'll finish this mission and head out there. Stay here for a while, search the village. Yeah. So why is my companion not on his horse and why isn't he wearing armor? Annoying. You two are in love, I don't care. Promise to bring you back, you must do it. 84% ineffective, failed. 39% crit success. That critical success seems to happen a lot. Cool, mission succeeded. Received 1680. Now that's good money, huh? Look at that. Landlord needs access. No, I don't want to do that. Recruit troops. 23. Remember, we're getting up to 30 troops now. See if we can't find that noble. Oh, that castle changed hands. The Empire looks like they won that battle. Is it Garios we're looking for? I think it might be Garios. Yes, good. Never forget that day, the day we learned that the old men who claimed they had the right to rule us were doddering incompetents. I was with the Vanguard. Neretzis apparently knew that the Batanians had planned an ambush. Cusate scouts had told him. But he never bothered to inform us, so up we went along a lovely wooded stream until the Batanian arrows started whooshing in from all sides. We had our shields, but you could only point them in one direction at once, so we started to drop, one by one, till the Batanian falxmen were screaming out of the trees. Ordinarily, they'd be very vulnerable to archers, but, well, old Neretzis hadn't thought to send any along with us. They came upon us, chopping and slashing, and we fought until we broke. I ran too. And any man who tells you he wouldn't in those circumstances is a liar. And I was sitting in the cold woods later that night, hiding with other fugitives, listening to the barbarians whoop and holler as they chopped off heads as trophies. I promised them that no Calradian soldier should again be led into battle by an emperor who knows so little of war. Excellent. So who's the next person we've got to talk to? I don't need to go there anymore. 4 out of 10. I love that our speed is above 6. And we're looking at a decent group of fighters right now. At this point, I think, yeah, let's upgrade these lads. Oh, yeah. Imperial Legionary, max level infantryman. Is it just me, or have they shortened the tech tree of all the troops? Like, there seem to be less levels of troops. We have 8, we have 9 frontline people, we have 5 archers, and then a bunch of recruits. That's our 30 people. Of the 30 in our party, it's 4 of us, so that actually means we've got 26 regular troops. So let's go for 13 and 13. Thanks, Leicester. I think I'm pretty relaxed and chilled, unless I'm playing Blood Bowl, in which case, yeah, rage comes out. Looters. I wonder if we are almost strong enough to go take on that base, base of mountain bandits we found. I love hate Blood Bowl. It's simultaneously the worst and best game ever. It's like, I'm keen to see what they do with Blood Bowl 3, but at the same time, I'm a little nervous that they're gonna, you know, screw it up, frankly. I would like some information about how many total horses I'm carrying. 10, 22, 25, so 30 horses, not including the ones that we are riding. So we've got 30 horses in total. So total party size now. Let's increase it up to 34. Because then it'll be 30 regulars plus 4 specials. Specials being myself plus my retinue. And then we can do 12 infantry, 12 archery, and then the balance can be horsemen. Family feud, we'll try this. How much are you looking to pay? 550. Fine. So we know this time, in this kind of mission, ask who you're supposed to talk to. Talk to Arion. There he is. So what do you guys reckon? When is the right time for us to join one of the noblemen, or pledge ourselves to a nobleman? Alt. Hold down left alt. One of the tips. To Leblenion. Over there. Does pledging still work like it did in the first one, where you get a daily retainer to actually pay for your troops, basically? Yeah, we can pledge soon. We just gotta choose which faction we want to pledge to, though. It's definitely going to be Empire of some sort. If we go Western Empire, they're looking quite strong. But these Kurgits are looking rough. What faction is this? Western Empire. We can make our own empire, but I don't fancy myself as being enough of a badass to do that yet. Gary Tops. We're taking him to Gary Tops. So you can merge with the army and get paid reputation you accumulate. Reputation accumulate bringing into the army, or the reputation that I accumulate while I'm in the army. I should become a vassal. So I want to be paid that retainer. I want to be a vassal so I can get paid just to be fighting in the name of that particular person. I always found that to be the most useful. Mercenary work. That's pretty much what I was thinking. Don't tell me we got this shit again. Is this fucking idiot not following us? It's a bar that fills up when you chill in the army. Yeah, but what does just chilling in the army mean? You just ride around with the army and do nothing. Yeah, that's my dog. Can you guys hear him? You can. I'm looking at the mic. He's an old Steffy. Crazy dog. So is it just me or are these Family Feud missions broken now? Help with the problem. Great misfortune. My daughter, headstrong girl. We'll go find her. Good. My dog isn't sad, he's just old. Take Arion. Where the fuck is this idiot? We got the same shit now. I'm just gonna cancel these Family Feud missions now. They're annoying. I can't get him to appear on the map. Pick from last seen at Leblenion. So he's here with us. Character skills. How do I reject a mission? Because seriously, fuck this. Family Feud. Look for clues. Villages around Leblenion. So I think my dog keeps barking like it because he's lived with my parents most of his life in a very small house. Now he's with me in this enormous house. And he's not accustomed to having all the space, so I think it kind of freaks him out a little bit. Go up towards Carfinion. reached the village. So far, these find the person's missing daughter seems to be like the real money makers. That and delivering herd. Yep, I know how this goes. I don't know, he's not forcing you. Click, start convincing. Success. 39%, 19%. Critical success, again. Those numbers can't be right. That's the second crit success we've gotten. I mean, I'm not going to complain. I'll take the money. Look at that. 1,700 gold. Family feud, that can fuck. That can fuck off. Deliver herd, we'll do that. Yeah, we're not in a state to pillage villages any time soon. We'll get there. Oh no, they totally changed it. It's wonderful. So look, I'm busy leading cattle right now, and they literally pop into your inventory, because I remember having to run behind them in the old game. Oh, it was so annoying. Also, I'm just curious, can I commission a ship into the smithy, go to the arena, Heaven District? Desert horse. So what am I saving up money for? I think let's just save up 10,000 gold and then buy ourselves a really nice set of armor. For booze. Yeah, running behind the cows was the worst, and then especially when you came across a group of enemies that you couldn't defeat, and then you had to run away, and then you'd lose the cows, and it just sucked. Deliver the herd. We missed the mutton pie. Task. Here's your cows. 400 gold. So I want to try a bit of smithing, but to do that, we need to get, is it a Psy? No, it's a scimitar. Ooh, throwing axes. Damage, 70 invalid. Wow, invalid damage, that sounds horrible. Throwing daggers, 30 PS, back amount, 3. They do so little damage. Broadblade javelin, stack amount 5. 101 pierce. Why are they so expensive if they're not as good as the harpoons? Are they way less? Broadblade, they're way less. 113 pierce missile speed, accuracy, stack amount. The reed. 121 pierce, that's like 2,000 gold. Okay, food variety we can do better. Are those olives? Oh, I keep thinking that's 110 gold. No, not. Grain, grapes, meat, dates, beer, butter, cheese, wine. Tea oil actually counts as food, even though it's not marked as food there. Hardwood, it's by how many? 5. Iron ore, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. into the smithy. Aha! So how does this work? Wooden one-handed grip, flat pommel. One-handed sword, swing speed, cut damage 49. Oh, we've got to refine first, hardwood into charcoal. Refine. Okay, so smithing's increasing. Okay, this is cool. Charcoal, iron ore. How much charcoal do we have? We have 2. Oh, this is cool. Okay, so we should start collecting hardwood, which we turn into charcoal. Okay, so hardwood and iron ore. We're gonna be a smith. Smelt, forge, simple war sword blade. Oh baby, look at the stuff. A pointed falchion. Difficulty 40. What do we need? We need 4 wrought iron, 1 crude iron. Confused. Yes, add the grip. Add that. Like, how do you, like, commit it? Well, it doesn't matter. We need to do a lot of refining first. That would actually be pretty cool, because if we become a skilled smith, all we have to do is buy ore and wood, which is cheap. And then through our own incredible skill, we can forge it into weapons and then make money selling the weapons and, of course, using the weapons. How are we going to learn new recipes? I don't know. I would presume it's just from actually doing the smithing work. Byproducts. We should start keeping our eyes open here in these villages for wood, woody wood and iron ore. Stobbie has gained a level. That's what I want to see. Ooh, horses. But we have plenty of horses. In a level, I have a focus point. One-handed axe type is equipped. One-handed sword type is equipped. Shield bash causes additional damage. Throwing, we're kicking ass at throwing so far. I really want to get to concealed carry, but I need 125. Oof. Tactics. Yes, cavalry attacks cause more morale loss. Excellent. I really want to get leadership going. I want that trickle XP. Faction Batania, but how do I know? Primary production is dates. Grapes. Oh, that's pretty cool. So you look at the villages, primary production is salt, silver ore. Oh dude, throwing weapons are the best. If you haven't seen what happened last night, I was running at full tilt with my sword, with my horse, and I threw a javelin at a looter, and this is this huge area. I got lucky, it hit the looter in the head and did 392 damage to the head. Look at how cheap that silver ore is. I must be able to make a profit off of that. Surely. Okay, bear in mind, we paid 108 for silver ore. I meant to have a pen and paper with me so I can make notes of what I'm paying. Someone just type in chat, silver 108, please. Some help with the problem. Let's find your daughter. This will give us good money. I'm quite liking that it feels like our money is okay. We're not struggling, but I do recall feeling like in the previous Mountain Blade that I had to pledge like ASAP, but I don't feel like I have to pledge now. The clues, tracks of the kidnapper. We don't have any tracking skill. So at some point I'm sure we'll get tracking skill. Family feud, I'm not going to take those anymore. Artopis. What's their primary production? Midlands Palfrey. Where are we going? Artopis. Also, one thing I wish I knew from the beginning is that horses are so important. So if you can find a village that breeds horses, you can buy horses quite cheaply. Because literally what we're doing is we have 35 people in our party. Arion. Wait, didn't I tell him to fuck off? I'm playing as Imperials. Traveling. You know what, mate? You can fuck right off if you can do. Nerd. Fucking nerd. And each person here has a horse. And we have 10, 22, 25, 30. So 34. Bonuses, look at our speed, 6, and that allows us to run down looters quite quickly. Probably Western Imperials, or, well, our color scheme is red and gold, so we'll see whichever of the Imperials matches our color scheme. It's a very important way to choose who you're going to fight for. You have to match the color scheme. I can already see these kind of missions are going to get a little bit tedious, because you always have to go 2 villages away, and when you find the people you're looking for, they're always in the same spot. So they should probably add a randomizer into that. Wait for Oberon to get here in case this becomes a fight. You know, forget that. I can fight this guy myself easily. Bit paid to get you back. Father loves you. 39% ineffective. 15% ineffective. Want to marry a corpse? Be a massacre, mate. Oberon, it just bitch slapped him with his blade. Oberon, my friend, nicely done. That was such a cool animation. It's like, I slap your face with my blade. Train troops, that is a shitty mission. I don't want to do that. Kidnap daughter to you have defeated the rogue. I need to bring her to the quest. Is she in my party? Yes, she is. So where are we taking her? Garangolia. Sell her, Jesus, dude. Want that money. Yeah, I saw a great meme based off of that, where it was like COVID approaching 2019, and then it shows COVID-19 over Lancelot as he's running, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, bam! Okay, so hang on, let's take a look at this map. Which of the Empire... See, like, this is... What faction is that? Vlandia. Now, we don't want to join with Vlandia. Let's join with... Who's this? Western Empire. Western Empire is doing well. This is... Western Empire. Also, we're moving fast enough now. Good. This is, we can start slaughtering looters now as we come across them. Send in the troops. A couple of wounded. That's fine. Looters I'm not going to bother with. Not worth ransoming. Okay, so 7 is 10 is 11. That's 12. And then all the rest are going to be archers. Archers are up to 8 in total. Those looters are fighting against villagers. Help the villagers. Send in the troops. And it helped with relations. Awesome. Okay, good. Southhell, thanks for reminding me. We're actually sitting with a couple of resources in our inventory. What did we buy? We bought silver. We bought silver for 105. Look at this. So this has increased relations. So we plundered gold. That's great. But helping peasants being attacked seems to be amazingly good for helping with reputation. But let's keep doing that whenever we can. Okay, so 5, 9, 10 archers. That's 4, that's 7, 8 archers, 9, 10 archers. Now let's see how much we get for silver here, bearing in mind that we paid 108 for our silver. And I must remember, I want to start buying up iron ore and wood wherever I can find it. Crude iron, iron ore, cotton... 175, yeah, we paid 100 odd for it, so we're going to make good profit with that. Hell yes. Keep the iron ore, keep the crude iron and the hardwood. Sell all of that shite. 4,000 gold, baby! Is it time? Is it time? Well, first of all, let's buy shoulder pads for all, shoulder pads for the lads. Scarf, that's no good. Imperial studded shoulders, you're welcome. Imperial padded shoulders. And 3,600. So how much am I going to need to spend to get an improvement in some sort of Roman style? I think, do we go for lamellar? Or mail over leather? 5,000, 1,000. Imperial studded. 18 body. Imperial studded leather. 18, 8 and 2. Oh yeah, that'll do nicely. It's only 1,000. Should we give this studded leather to, not Valia, Oberon the Robber? And then this gambeson with skirts, we can give out gambeson with skirts. Studded fur. Lads, looking good. Cotton, we can sell. Iron ore. Okay, so 1,700. We're gonna buy. You know what? I think we shouldn't be buying hardwood. Unless it's this cheap here. Hardwood. Let's go 20 hardwood. I'm just wondering whether iron ore. Let's see. 55. It's quite cheap here. Seems like. Can buy at Rote for 38. I think we're probably better off finding villagers. I'm almost certain that we're going to get iron ore and wood for cheaper at the villagers. We're just going to find out what their primary productions are. Look, primary production is hog. Hardwood. We could have gotten it cheaper there. Grain. Olives. Silver ore. In any case, while we let the lads heal up, because bear in mind, we've got a bunch of wounded. Our daily cost is getting up there. Let's just run around and do some shopping and some trading. Products, silver ore, 161. No, that's more expensive. It was a lot cheaper last time we were here. Salt, Midden's palfrey. I mean, I suppose there's no reason you can't buy horses and sell them for profit that way. Salt for 41. That doesn't seem like it has a good margin on it. We've got to find the village that's going to give us iron ore. Midland's palfrey. Does this have production? No. Dates. It makes sense that an iron ore village would be in the mountains. Store to the horses. I would assume for meat, but I don't think that would be very effective money-wise. Olives. Also, we're heading the wrong way. We should be heading east. Head over to Rote. Nice mountainous area. Meat and hide. Is hide used in blacksmithing? Because I want to do a lot of blacksmithing. Render or die. Send the troops. I forgot to sell my prisoners, which we will do the next major city. Looters, fuck them. I mean, there's no reason that we can't buy hogs and then sell them. I mean, hell, you can make profit off of anything. I think I should get in the habit of, when I go past a village, see what its primary production is. And then if the price is in green, I believe that means it is well below its usual price. So, 30 gold. Butter, let's buy some butter. How much cheese do we have? A whole lot. So out of interest's sake, let's buy 5 hogs. Where are my hogs? And see what kind of profit we can make. At the Imperial Village. What is your primary? Hardwood. Sheep. Olives. Iron ore, there we go. Only 44, hell yes. Hogs bought for 30 and we can sell them for 20, so not profitable at all. Money's getting a bit low. $159, so we've got 2 days worth of money. I need to make some cash, I need to make it now. Indeed, Aegis, it's fucking great. Getting some looters, it'll be just the thing for us. We'll get some money. 4.8 speed, 5.8. You see how having so many horses is making this so much easier. Thanks for the follow, McDorito. Send in the troops. Just a few wounded, no kills. Did they release Bannerlord? We're playing Bannerlord, dude. Well, it's this is release 1.0.0, so technically it's still in beta, but bloody great. I love it. Okay, so stop there. Ask you for your name. I'm Stobicus. The content is absolutely there. I know Adram. Where do we find Adram? Yep, four. I mean, I suppose we shouldn't be surprised. That's Tail World. Go to the tavern, sell prisoners, trade. Hogs we bought for 30, so we're making 10 profit per hog. Hardly worth it. Broad arming sword. Let's enter the smithy and refine. Charcoal and iron ore. What am I missing? Rest and spend time before you can do this action. Ah, okay. Don't want you spamming. I suppose that's fair enough. Trade. Beer, wow. That's good profit on that beer. We bought that for like 40 odd. Let's just really focus on the money now for a bit. Let's look for some jobs. And of course we will run down looters wherever we can find them. 209 for a cow. I'm wondering if I got tired so quickly because I have low skill in smithing. Caravans are good targets for money. I'm not up to fighting caravans just yet. Looters aren't even worth ransoming. You get like 5 gold for them. Forget that. Veteran infantryman, imperial legionary. That's going to cost us 300. Should I even be doing that? Yeah, of course. 8 Imperial Legionaries. Hell yes. 9, that's 10. So 10 frontline people, that's 1. 5. That's 5 is 10 and 10. So now I can just alternate. 12 and 12. We need a more skilled surgeon because it is taking friggin' forever. We're never at full strength. I suppose I shouldn't be surprised by that. No jobs. One thing I really want them to do is add the little exclamation marks above villages and cities. Needs access. I don't want to do that. But you can go to a city if you know there's a mission there. I wish I knew right from the beginning how important the horses are. Would have made such a big difference. I could capture looters. It's some money, it's not nothing. Goska. So the horses help determine your speed on the map. So look at our speed now, 5.9. And if we open up here and go to their party speed, my base speed is only 4.7, meaning that without any horses, I can move at 4.7. Cavalry is helping us. And look at that though, footmen are on horses, plus 1.04. What we spent yesterday, we spent like 8 hours just running after looters being either at the same speed or less than them. So you'll notice I have 24 plus 10, 34. My maximum is 56, but I'm not going above 34 because we only have 34 horses in total. So what I should actually start doing is find a place like this when I have more money next time. Find a place that breeds Midland Palfreys, which are pretty decent saddle horses. Look how cheap they are. And then really, I'm only going to... my number of horses will determine my total number of troops. Because otherwise, you're just so slow. You can't move around the map at any ability to actually chase down anything. I don't want to fence stolen goods. Is it time to pledge? I think it's time to pledge. Let's find a nobleman and pledge. Deliver the herd. Yes, we'll do that. Omor. We're going to Omor. Where's Omor? There it is. One problem is delivering herds can often take quite a long time. Yarios. Is this our emperor? I think it's our emperor. Stobicus. It's been a while. I'd like to discuss. Proposal might benefit us both. Okay, so that's trading. I can give him a gift. I'd like to enter your service. My sword is yours for the right sum. We don't need hide swords currently because we're not at war. We should fortune elsewhere. Okay. So that should be easy enough to understand once they're at war. How can the Empire not be at war? Weird. 221, that's quite expensive. I'm gonna have to go out there and go talk to my dog. His name is Baron, he's an 11-year-old. Amstaff, American Staffy. So we think he has a bit of pitbull in him. He is the dumbest dog I've ever encountered in my life, but he's also one of the most lovely animals. He's so friendly, but so stupid. God damn it, he's dumb. Oh shit, I shouldn't have upgraded there. I didn't have money for that. Look at that, no deaths, no injuries. Thing is, we don't have enough money to actually even be able to upgrade our troops. Shit. Our daily gold change is 211. I will say the daily gold numbers inflate quite quickly. I got this fucking dog. Come here, looters. I need your money. Render or die. You all know the drill by now. How much gold did we loot? Not a whole lot. The dumber the better. Love him to bits, though. Such a lovely dog. I mean, being an old Staffy, he farts horrendously, and he just, his breath stinks, but he just, I wouldn't change him for the world. Yeah, male cat's just a cat. Oh, well, female cat's also a cat. There isn't a gender term cats, is there? I don't know. Mountain bandit's good. A tomcat. Oh. Speaking of cats, I am getting myself a Russian Blue. I think 7 more weeks and my kitten will be ready for me to collect. Kraz the Smith. Can't wait. My little kitten is going to be so fucking cute. God, I can't wait. Topicus. Here are your animals. 450 gold. The money is looking a little rough. I feel like I should be trading, but you need money to trade in the first place. Guys, give me a sec. I need to go talk to this damn dog. I need to see what his problem is.
Welcome to intermission. Yeah, intermission. Welcome to intermission. Yeah, intermission.
My dog is literally sitting at the entrance to the house, looking out into the garden and just howling. I think he saw a bird. Okay, so what do we have here? This is my favorite little thing to have with coffee. A Stroopwafel. Stroopy. That's not the invisible cup, it's the cup of the void. Yes. I love these Stroopwafels, they're so good. God bless the Dutch. Oh yes. Okay, this is a disaster. This is the worst. The mug. Okay. The mug is bigger than the Stroopwafel. So now I can't put the waffle over the mug to soften it up. No one has a worse laugh than I do. Disaster. It's a disaster. Army of poachers. That sounds like my kind of job. I'm Stobicus. Need some help? Crush them. Go to Chornibus and kill them all. I have no doubt they make you fat, but I'm doing two-a-days these days. Well, since Bannerlord came out. I was working out quite a lot. Party-wise... Look at all these level-ups. Also, where'd the Imperial Crossbowman come from? I think that's a mislevel. The recruits, we will go up into archers there. So daily rate is 212. Crossbowmen. While we're here, let's get rid of these looters. Scoop waffle. Real good. Where are we going? Chornibus. Imperial Palatine Guard. Look at that. So what are we supposed to do? Go to Chornibus. The poachers he hired before are now out of control. Chornibus around midnight. Okay, what? So we just missed it. What happened? You can't just wait. Well, that's annoying. Yeah, we're paying 200 something a day. So what time is it? And can you literally not see what time it is exactly? Because what, do I just have to hang around here like this until midnight? Are they gonna show up? I mean, this is like not clear what I'm supposed to be doing. Yes, yeah, so another midnight has come and gone. We've just missed it. I'm getting fucking annoyed now. I mean, surely you would go into the village and then wait there and then the mission will proc. Like, why the hell doesn't it work that way? Well, we have enough money for another day, though. It's alt for more info. Sturgeon, militia archers, militia spearmen, veteran, troops, infantry, and ranged. Why don't you go to Chornibus around midnight and kill the poachers? We'll try one more time, just hanging around at regular speed, I think. Like, are they going to appear like a group like that, or...? It's not at all clear. See, it's midnight. Where the fuck are these poachers? I actually have to wait for it to get dark and then go into the town, because previously we went to the town and then waited there and then midnight happened, but it didn't trigger. Shit, now we are running out of money. $244. Okay, we can wait for night, then enter the town. So you actually have to make it proc when it's late at night. That doesn't make any sense to me. Like, it would feel so much more intuitive that you enter the town, click there, wait for a while, and then the mission procs. You know, like when you were guarding the village, you take... Okay, so does this count as night time yet? Or is that midnight? There we go. Arrived and requested a meeting. Okay, talk to the leader of the poachers and see what he has to say. You had to hunt us. I want you to know that we are men of people who take from the rich and give to the poor. The man who paid you is living high on the hog and never cares how common folk live, but we care now. Choice is yours. Better die. Come to an agreement, maybe. I mean, I put a lot of points into negotiating. I should be using it. Look, you're not bad people. Just leave the old grounds, and I will make sure your crimes will be forgotten. Success. 59%. If there will be a fight here. Innocence will suffer two. This is how you care about these people. Critical fail. Guess we're fighting. Leave now. One way or another, you're outlaws. Prepare to die. Now, I imagine we are going to be fighting against archer-heavy enemies, and this is going to go badly for us. I don't want to be on foot for this one.
Footmen! Forward!
We do have a bunch of high-level infantry, though, so maybe we'll be okay. Where are these fucks?
Charge! Infantry! Move!
You know
after
what?
Me!
Everyone on me.
Soldiers! Will! Look that way!
This is, wait, this is turning into a fuck
move.
Up now.
In fact, move!
The issuing of orders can be quite hard. Okay, we are taking arrow fire, so infantry. Charge.
Line formation!
Infantry, charge. Cavalry, charge. Archers, move forward. Oh, Jesus, there's a lot of them here. Issuing of orders is very clunky. I suppose it'll take a little getting used to, because what I'm accustomed to is putting my troops into groups before the battle, and then you just give specific orders to each group. But instead you have to go like this. One is infantry, two is archers, three is cavalry. If I go cavalry, movement, charge. Archers, movement, go here. Infantry, movement, go here. Okay. Who's calling me? Don't talk now, leave me alone, people. $1,200, okay. I would have liked more for that. But what now? Are we trading now leather for 131? Is that cheap? What is this? Why are we trading? I'm confused. Okay, so we've rebuilt our clan. We're still looking to investigate Neretzi's folly. What, so could I have just taken as much leather as I wanted there for helping the town? Salute. Okay. Lessons getting learnt the hard way. Get back to Imperial lands. Bullshit. The thing is that wasn't clear at all that was the case. That was your reward for helping the... At least like the first time that screen pops up, it should be like a little pop-up saying, okay, here, in addition to the money you're getting paid, the town will give you this. Help yourself. There were 11 stacks of leather there. That's like another 2,000 gold worth. That would have been worth more to me than what I was actually paid to do the mission. Surrender or die. No, man. Desporion, he's on mine. You tit. Are we carrying any prisoners? We are. No. But a trade. Town centre. Trade. We haven't lost any horses, have we? 10, 22, 25, 30. Okay, we haven't. 800 gold. Charcoal, iron ore. We've rested at least, so now we can enter the smithy, I suppose. We can refine charcoal and iron ore into crude. Must rest and spend time before you can do this action. How long? It's been days. Eh? Interesting. Gerios. I have to discuss on enter your service for the right sum. Not at war. How do I know what I'm supposed to? I'm going to keep asking nobles about this artifact that we have. Raganvad. Last Cyanir. Gundavling. So this looks like we're going to be talking. This is going to take us around the whole map pretty much. But this is a quest to make us talk to all the various powers, which I suppose is interesting enough. Quick check, do we need to replace any troops? 28 plus, we need 34, so 28 plus 5. Yes, we need one more little basic recruit. So what are these symbols here? Those are cheap cows. But we don't have much money. I'm hoping we can start running into better enemies to fight, because it's been nothing but looters for the last, you know, while. Okay, just more looters. Give us some mountain bandits. It's gonna be worth more. Sea raiders, 8 of them. Aha! Raganvad. Exactly who we're looking for. I love the Norse armor and the Norse helmets. Also, I like the slack-jawed look on a lot of these guys. What can you tell me about Pendrake? Yes, the day my father died, thanks to Britannian treachery. When they pledged to support us in the battle, we believed they would stand with us in the shield wall like men, but of course not the Britannian way. They sprung some woodland trickery up on the hills, killed off Nerezis' vanguard, and no doubt spent the rest of the battle whooping and boasting and chopping the heads off the men who were already dead. It was Sturgeons who met Nerezis' guard face to face. My father ordered me to stay back as he led them into battle, but he was at their head. He forced them back. Then they broke and ran for the shelter of their camp. We went and attacked their ramparts and broke them, but my father was hit by an imperial mace at the moment of his triumph and died. I'll never forget when a messenger ran to tell me that my father was dead. But I knew I must swallow my grief, because now I was king. I rode down into the ruins of the imperial camp to take their banner as a trophy, my inheritance won by my father and passed down to me. Oh, some of the boyars were insubordinate, but I have since showed them that I am master. Thank you. Now, who do we... Oh god, look at how quickly our money just fucking evaporates. My lord, I wish to discuss with you, Oberon. I'm listening. Your men shed their blood for you. I hear that their wages are late. Okay. Very well. I think we can sell. Kind of have to. Well, we're learning a lot about the economy in the game. I feel like we've maybe grown a little too quickly. We're up to 34 people. Maybe we should have gone to 20 and then stabilized at a few thousand gold, then go to 30. I might be able to clear out these bandits. Let's hope it's not too many sea raiders, because that could be quite rough. Okay, 13 sea raiders, that's eminently doable. Especially considering, well, I can't even afford that. Now hopefully these legionaries join us first. Yeah, these camps hopefully will be good money. I need the money desperately. Like, my followers are not great fighters. I think I should be keeping them at the bottom of the order. If this works the way that it worked in the other Mountain Blade, then these ones at the top are most likely to join us in the battle, which is obviously what I want. My Imperial Legionaries, I want them to fight with me. Wait until nightfall. Pack. Jeez, what time is it? I have to stop soon. 11:30. It doesn't normally load this long, and this is, I think maybe there's an error because the game's on my SSD, so it shouldn't be taking this long to load. Backstab, yes, this is a Sea Raider camp, but it looks like it's failing to load. Looks like it's a crash. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to stop for now anyway. I've got some admin I have to take care of today. Two p.m. So in 2.5 hours time, I'll be back. I need to return some phone calls, do some shit around the house. Okay, friends, I've got some work to do. We'll reconvene back here at 2 p.m., which is 2.5 hours time from now. And then we'll keep on. I forgot to save, though. I must get into the habit of pressing F5 between each mission. Okay, thanks for watching. See you guys later.